guys. Nishit, I'm going to come. I'm going to get you here. Okay, let's be quiet. Just give me about 15, 20 minutes, and then we will be out of this place. The first quality of a great leader is to be a great listener. So first thing, I hope that you will be quiet. Okay? So I'm giving that quality to you, that the first quality of a good leader is to be a great listener. You can listen, and you need not do anything about it. But you have to first listen, okay? What I'll do is I'll go over a little bit about what leadership is all about. You've already seen the parts which relate with the teamwork, because that's going to be required for you. I'm going to cover the section on leadership. What are those qualities that we look for in leaders, and what you can do in order to enhance your leadership qualities, okay? I'll be using two videos. I'll start with one, and I want to listen to it very, very carefully and read every bit of it, and then we will talk about it. Let's go and give me some volume. So do you want to be a leader? Now, so we just looked at a 2 minutes video which gives you a glimpse of what leaders are supposed to be doing. We will look at another piece which will give us an idea of how you can see a person and say that person is a leader or has great qualities of leadership. Remember that leadership is, it's about measuring from a scale of 0 to 100. You can be anywhere. It means that everybody has the potential to be a leader. After all, the scale is from 0 to 100, right? It is our responsibility to push ourselves to move from 0 to that level 100. So everybody you may see and you may admire, I will say, is a great leader, he may still not be at the 100%. He may still be at the 60 or 70%, which means your benchmark for leadership itself may be undefined at this point. So what do we consider as a leader, especially in the context in which you are going to be working, which Chirag told you that, listen, there are 8 guys, everybody's a leader. What happens when you have 8 leaders? So you're going to have clashes. And at 6:30, it's going to start. Because remember that each person's performance is not affecting the performance of that person, it is affecting the performance of the whole group. So if one person doesn't do well, he talked about frustration. I'm going to kill him. Right? It's going to happen. So as soon as the spirit of competition begins to come in, you will begin to see those differences. The idea as a leader is you need to carry everybody irrespective of the differences that are going to exist. You cannot blame people. You got to take the responsibility. Remember, as a leader, no matter who makes the mistake, you have to take the responsibility for it. You can't put the blame on others. Well, in real life, it doesn't happen that way. In real life, most people will try to push the blame onto somebody else. So if you have a boss and he makes the mistake, he will try to put it on you because you are below him and you can't go above him. Therefore, you are stuck, right? So look at yourself. Look at yourself in the capacity of a leader, how you can motivate the whole team. And it is the responsibility of every person to motivate each other in that. Let's look at the second clip.
Thank you.
I want to think about one of the things that is said there, that if you want to achieve something, you can't do it alone. You'll never be able to do it alone. So one of the qualities of good leadership is to seek out people, the people who can fill the gaps. And all of us as individuals have a weakness. And when we try to pull people towards us, we need to first assess what our weaknesses are. And we need to get people who are strong in the areas where we are weak. That's what makes a team work. So collectively, everybody becomes one complete individual. So you may have a strength, so you don't need somebody in that area with you. You are good enough. But there is a weakness that you have. When you get somebody to be part of your team, you should be looking for people based on your weaknesses and your strengths. Those are the ones that are going to give you that. Now, there is a leader in everyone. So you know where to find? Right in here. That's where the person is. And you need to discover that person in you. So you don't have to go and read books. You don't have to go into details of finding out where these leaders are found and where they are going to be trained. The leader is sitting right inside your heart. You just need to discover that person. Right? I always tell you this, that if there are problems in your life, 95% of the solutions to all those problems are within you. You don't need to go and search anywhere. Right? Like Vrushul is trying to see where the mosquitoes are. So solutions to all problems are within you. Good leaders always look inwards. Always try to look inwards. Good leadership is about looking inwards, understanding yourself, and deciding how you are going to forge ahead and who are those people who are going to be on your boat. Now remember that if you are on a boat and there are 8 people, everybody sailing in a different direction, where is the boat going to go? You'll be circling around. The puja is over. Come. So during these 3 days, we are going to test that what impact this is going to have on you, what we are talking today. Remember that there are going to be instances in these 3 days. If you hold your hands together tight, you will be able to cross the tide. It is possible. And it is the responsibility of each of you to carry your team to the top position. Some of these challenges that you will face can be mentally very exhausting and very frustrating. And you will get an example of it at 6:30 when we start. Physically not demanding at all. No physical demand. But mentally it's going to kill you. So as a leader, you need to keep your team composed. Another quality that you all always have to look, during this period, you're going to be getting a lot of help from a lot of people who are not participating. There are people who are in the kitchen, the housekeeping, all these people. You need to learn to respect them also. Remember that they are doing things for you. Compassion is a quality of good leadership. If you cannot be compassionate, you can't be a good leader. But compassion does not mean that you do everything that people want you to do. As a good leader, you need to decide when you need to be able to say, nope, sorry, can't be done. And when you should say, yes, let us do it. Not I'm going to do it. Let us do it. So I'll take you now to the third clip, which is going to give you an idea of what great leaders do and how they do it. And I want you to look at it and then we'll talk about it. that's what we call transformational leadership. One of the things that is always emerging from within. Everything is coming from within. So unless you get hold of that power of within, inside us, inside ourselves, that's where lies the whole potential to harness leadership. Now, I know everyone here wants to be successful. Anybody who doesn't want to be successful? Anybody who wants to be successful? No. So I'll tell you a short story. You can actually achieve that success. And there was a young person like you who met somebody who was very successful, and he said, "Hey, listen, you are really successful. I admire you. I want to become successful like you." So he looked at him and he said, "Oh, really? You really want to become successful like me? Okay, so meet me at 4 o'clock on the banks of the river." So he said, 4 o'clock in the morning. He said, "Yes, I want you to come at 4 o'clock on the banks of the river and we will talk about success." So the guy reaches there at 4 o'clock. For a change, he had to get up at 4 o'clock and go. So he reached there and he said, "Okay, I'm here, so tell me the secret to success." He said, "Let's walk into the river." He said, "Listen, I just want to be successful. Just tell me how to be successful. I don't want to get into the river." He said, "No, I can't tell you. You got to walk with me." So he started walking, so till here. And he said, "Okay, now tell me, how do I become successful?" He said, no, let's walk more. He said, "Listen, this is really cold. Can you just tell me right here and I'll go back?" They said, "No, let's walk." So he kept on taking him until here they came. And he said, "Okay, can you tell me now? Please, what's the secret?" And he said, "Okay, I'm going to tell you." And he put his head inside the water and he kept on holding it in. Kept on holding. And then, when he started almost feeling that he's going to drown, he struggled and he came out. And he said, "Listen, you are a crazy man. I thought you are a successful person and you are going to teach me the secret of how to be successful. You almost drowned me." He said, "Listen, son, tell me something. What did you want most when you were deep inside that water and I was not letting you come out?" He said, "I wanted to breathe." He said, "How badly did you want to breathe?" He said, "I really wanted to breathe." He said, "Okay, the day you decide to have success, as much as you wanted to breathe the air, that's the day you will become a successful person. That's the secret to success." Always remember this. If your desire to become successful is as great as you wanted to breathe when you were inside, then you will become. Remember, he wanted to breathe very badly. And he struggled and he came out to breathe. That's the only way you achieve success. So if you feel that you are going to do your BBA and LLB and BSc and MBA and I'll become successful, you are on the wrong train. It's going somewhere else. Right? So you also have to be on the journey to self-discovery along with that qualification. Qualifications are good. They are good. I'm not saying that you don't need qualifications. There are more people in the world who are successful because they are qualified, or they are qualified and they are successful, than those people who are not qualified and successful. So everybody talks about Bill Gates and, you know, Steve Jobs and Dhirubhai Ambani. They're known because they did not have good qualifications, but they became successful, right? But there are very few of those. Don't get into that, right? It's like I once told somewhere, that somebody said that, you know, all these people didn't go to college, they all became successful. They all dropped out of college. And my response was, don't try this at home. This is a very dangerous one. Or at least don't try on yourself. It may not work. You may not have success and you may not have qualification. At least you have one, right? So the essence of what we are trying to tell you is that anything that you want to achieve is within your powers. And there is only one person who can make it happen for you, and that's you. The day you begin to take the responsibility for yourself, that's the day the path to success will become visible. Please also remember, it is not a one-point action. It's a process. So it's not that today you finish these 3 days and you say, okay, now I've decided to become successful, and you know, fourth day, Monday when you come, you expect that you should be successful. No, it's a process, right? It's a process of self-introspection first. You start from there. Who am I? What am I doing? What's the purpose of my life? Do I want to do anything? What is it that I want to achieve? You could be in anything. For example, a lot of you may come from family businesses. And one of the feelings that's there in your mind is, I don't have to worry about anything. I've got a car, I've got servants. You know, after all, everything is there. Why should I need to worry about anything? I've got a license to life, right? Let me tell you something. If you really become something, you don't need it. If you really become something on your own, you don't need any of those things. If you don't become, that's going to last for 2 years. That's it. You will blow it completely. So if you have your own family business, begin to think, how can I move it in a direction which is different, which is more rewarding, not only financially. So when I use the term rewarding, I'm not implying that it is only money. Okay? In fact, I'll tell you one thing. One of the principles that I have always followed, and I know a lot of people who have followed, they have never worked for money. They have worked for the passion. It is the passion that they follow. They pursue their passion, and the money somehow keeps on following them. So don't chase money. Chase your passion. Money is attached to that passion. The more you work on that passion, the faster that money is going to come. And you don't even have to ask for it. It's coming. You turn behind it, you'll see that it's coming. So create a passion, create a goal, chase that passion. Don't turn back once the wall comes in front of you. And this is what we most of the time do, that we are trying to do something, all of a sudden we are confronted with a barrier, and we say, okay, next one. Let's go back. You turn around. Don't take a U-turn. Try and find a way to jump over that wall. Because remember that you've already traveled a certain path. If you're going to go back, you're going to waste that much time. Don't give up so fast. Don't give up so fast. Hold on. Take rest. Collect all the energy. Find a way to jump. And if you really start looking for ways to jump, you will be able to jump it. 99% of the people who have failed in life just gave up at the last minute when they were about to become successful. They withdrew. And that's the reason I'm saying, don't withdraw yourself from your success story. You got to write your destiny. Everybody may say, and all scriptures and books, and everybody may say that your destiny has been written. And you can't change it now. So jao sab log ghar mein baith jao. It's all written. I always say that God left your destiny blank. He said, you go and you write it now. You decide what you want to write. So the choice is yours. That's where leadership qualities have to come. So never feel that, oh, it's all done, I can't do it. We are so much frustrated by failures in life that we forget to see the success in front of us. Your friend says something, made a comment, maybe a derogatory comment or a comment that you don't appreciate, and for 4 days, we shall die in the mind, right? So we always say, don't give a rent-free space in your mind for those kind of people. They said something, forget it. What is the purpose? The purpose is for you to have your focus. There are going to be people who are going to move you away from your focus. If you concentrate too much on those kind of things, they win, you lose. So the idea is that even if people tell you something that you don't like, forget it. Because if you don't forget it, they have won. You can't let them win. So you got to keep your focus very, very clear. Have the determination and go. But yes, let me also tell you at the end that there is no success if you are not willing to give your sleep. Did I scare all of you? Now, when I said don't take it in the literal sense, otherwise some of you will faint. What I mean is that you bring a balance. In your age, you need 6 hours or 7 hours of sleep. You should sleep. But if you say that you need 14 hours of sleep, then I'm very, very sorry. That's not the right thing to do. So from tomorrow, begin to think. Is 7 hours a good amount of sleep? For a healthy body like you all, 7 hours is it. That's it. So we thought one of the objectives of this program is to try to get you away from sleep. Right? Because you all are used to not sleeping. You sleep at 3 o'clock, you sleep at 4 o'clock. Right? One day at 11 o'clock, I think Pallav sent me a message on my Facebook. Yeah, he said, something he said. I said, oh, what are you doing? So I keep on getting some messages from some people, and somebody once sent me a message at 1:30 in the night. I was working, and he said, sir, how are you? I said, I'm fine. So how are you? Sir, I'm also fine, sort of. I said, sort of. What's happening? He said, tell me, is it something urgent? Says, no. So he said, sir, but why are you awake? So I told him that, you know, there is a difference between you being awake and me being awake. You are awake because you are looking for a purpose. I am awake because I have a purpose. Right? So all of you, no, Pallav didn't, Pallav was more decent. He was 11 o'clock, 10:30, 11, you know, that's a normal time. But 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, sometimes I do work very, very late because I don't need the 7 hour sleep like you all need now. I can manage with 5 hours, so sometimes if there is excess amount of work, I try to catch up. That's why I said I have a purpose, you guys don't have a purpose, right? So what I'm trying to say is create that passion in yourself, right? Many times you may feel that, are we pushing you too much? Zindagi bhar sirf padhai karna hai. Is age mein sirf padhte rahenge to phir kya karenge? Those are normal questions that should come to your age group. There is nothing wrong. In fact, if it doesn't come, then there is something wrong. I'm really scared then, right? That's a normal thing to happen. But what is our objective? Our objective is to try and help you bring and live a life of balance. There is nothing that you can achieve without a sacrifice. So now each of us have to think about only one thing. How much of our present are we willing to sacrifice for our future. That's all. That's the only thing you need to decide. What is the amount of our present joy that we are willing to sacrifice to achieve something in the future? If you can answer that question, then you can bring a very, very good balance in life. You need to study, you need to spend time with your friends, you need to be able to go to the movies, you need to spend time with the family. How many of you have had, okay, be honest, how many of you have had dinner in the last 1 week with your family members? So, good. That's one thing that you must always do, is spend time with your family, together. That's the most important thing, okay? All right, I can understand those who are in the hostel, you are family for yourself, right? So you are having dinner every day. All right, we are not going to be talking. Now, Chirag did mention to you that this is the first time we are going to be talking during these 3 days. And I saw so much happiness. Okay, this is not about you listening. This is all of us working together to understand certain things. Now we will be meeting Sunday evening here around 5 o'clock. So there are no more lectures, no bhashan. We wanted to only you to understand the concept of team and leadership. Okay?